Hello everybody and welcome to this tutorial, how to create this fractal-like looking ring very easily via the loft command. So I will show you how we can set up the needed sketches for the loft command and then via loft and twist and some cleanup work, create actually this first version. And then through a little bit of further manipulation and a little bit of cleanup and then a trim on the side, develop another ring where we have the structure on the outside, but the inside is nice and cleaned up, so it's comfortable to wear. This file is being shared with you, so please go ahead to download it so you can study it. As always, you will see lots of tips and tricks, so stay tuned and let's get ready. Here inside a new file, first we would like to make sure units are set to millimeter and our snap to elements like here are turned on. The ring we would like to make has a diameter of 18 millimeters, so 9 millimeters for the radius. The easiest way to start, we go to top view and I will draw myself a line 9 millimeters. So that's the radius. And then 3 or 4 millimeters, there we are, 3.5 and 3.5. I make this a little bit bigger. There we are. And then let's go with 2 millimeters and 2 millimeters. And then we plot this over. Perfect. These lines I will remove. They were only helpers, and now there I have a nice clean 7 millimeter wide, 2 millimeter thick cross section. Cool. Okay, so to create a ring out of a loft command, I need 4 at a minimum, but then the ring looks kind of wonky, so ideally I need 8. So that's very easy to do. We select this section, then go to the now move and rotate and turn on copy, and then we rotate this 90 degrees and 180 and 270. Now we have 50% done. We turn everything off, open our overview, select the two sketches. Let's rotate and copy 45 degrees one time, and now there we have all the needed extra elements. Pretty cool. Okay, so now the fun actually can start. We'll go to Loft in Tools and then start selecting all our elements here. There we are. There, there, and there. Sweet. And I will twist this one that way. What happens when I twist it this way? This is getting too tight. So let's see if we can undo this. It does not. Okay, let's restart. So you have to be careful how you're twisting the surface. There we are. There and there. Very good. And then let's maybe twist it this way, and then we twist it this way, and we twist it this way. Beautiful. Okay. There's actually quite nice now this wave pattern we see there. And I made the ring, the band, actually on purpose much wider than really necessary, because if I take a look at this, I have really sharp edges if I would make this ring, and that's not going to be very comfortable to wear. So I will, from a top view, draw myself now kind of like the proportion of how wide this ring actually should be. Now this rectangle which I created, I simply move down and you see how this one line moves with it. So be careful which line you select. There. Very good. Now, this we can extrude, cut through. This makes our ring disappear. So we switch to intersect. Oh, look at that. How beautiful is this? Isn't that cool? Yeah, I think so too. Okay. Looks really nice and abstract. Looks very complicated, very labor intensive, and you saw how easy this actually is. So how can we make this ring even better? Down here, I don't want to have these deformation issues. And from here to here, maybe I can patch in a small blend. So let's see. I draw myself a line. Haha. So this is 45 degrees. Very good. So you see here, I'm drawing this. Then I will see if I can just move this one without manipulating the other sketches. Correct. And then I cut through and clean this up. Beautiful. And this profile here around this axis, I will revolve till this closes 90 degrees. Yeah, that doesn't actually look too bad. Now the bottom is much, much cleaner and the rest is quite cool. These two elements I can select, fuse together into one piece. Let's call this maybe design one. Okay. And here we put all this together into one folder. Let's call this sections. And I have this one and this one. So these two I will move out. And I call this top. And I call this wedge. I just give those names, which makes sense to me. Please feel free to develop your own naming. So I would like to have more stuff going on there. Can I do that? Okay, so if I want more, well, I need more elements. So that means I can select via move and rotate this one, center this, make sure this is really perfectly centered, 45 degrees divided by 2, 22.5, one direction. Very good. Then this is the other direction. I can select this one. There we are. And while the command is still active, you see how I select the missing section there. Pretty good. So up here now I have more details. Let's see what happens when we loft this all together. The bottom, not much really should change. So we just keep this more simplified. There we are. Very good. And then we can work symmetrical. So you in, so every, be careful which one you select, every second there, okay. So what happens when I do this? Yeah, that pulls it down there. So maybe here I could have used actually an additional sketch tube. But for the moment, let's keep it the way how it is. I will actually now try to clean this up somewhat different. I will draw here a line. Very nice. And down here, a target base at the bottom, and I can either connect this via a line or with a spline. I will go with a line and then see, yeah, this looks good, this position in here. So this is a good angle, very nice. Okay, so let's delete this, and then these two lines I will lock so they can't move. Can go to the arc command, draw myself an arc, select the arc or move the point. There we are. Bring this one to there, and then to make things even, we can make them equal. Very good. Now you see at the bottom, the base gets wider. Now there's a question if we would like this. So this sketch we just created, so these lines are part of the section sketch. So I only select those and then move this out. Here again, let's go with the intersect. Now that actually doesn't look too bad. Maybe it's good that at the bottom it gets a little bit wider, makes it more dynamic. And now there you can see how we have a lot more happening just up there, because we kind of like created more compartments for the geometry there. And then two down here, it naturally really straightens out a little bit more. Yeah, beautiful. And from the top, that's also really nice. Now how this actually gets bigger and smaller. Really beautiful. For the inside, now this might maybe not be that super ideal. What else can we do there? So when we select this face, can we shrink this a little bit? But you see it's a little bit tricky. So we have to be careful with the way how we do this. What about this? Also there, it works to a certain degree, but now again, as you see, it has some problems there. Now, do we really need actually this detail in the inside? Isn't this more on the outside more important? No, now we can make a case for that. So that means, okay, let's make a ring. I make the ring on purpose a little bit smaller. Then I extrude this one out. So there we have now a big cylinder, and this cylinder I start scaling a little bit. And I'm trying to see, can I get this close without, unfortunately, there getting over it? Yeah, that's too bad. So we have a little bit of a dimensional problem. I can fix this by maybe making this a tiny tick smaller on top. That's one possibility. So this one I hide for the moment. I can, with a finger, double tap on this sketch. So we zoom in. And then here, this I would like to lock, because we moved the sketch, some of the constraints went away. And now when I zoom in more, I have to see, so maybe one grid and one grid. Very good. And then we do an intersect again. And let's see, is this better? Yeah, it is. Beautiful. Okay. So that means I can bring this a little bit more in, so you see what we have there. You and you, we join together. Thank you. Then we cut through on the intersect. Now we have this solid piece. And now we are going to drill a hole. 9 millimeters, there we are. I prefer modeling this way, making a cylinder while the other object is hidden, and then I remove it from it. There, look at that. Now we actually have a nice design where just the outside area is really beautiful. The inside area is nice and smooth, so that means we can go ahead and fillet it quite comfortably. These sharp edges, it's up to us. Do we want to keep those? But because how I cut everything, I created really clean geometry, like an edge that goes from corner to corner. Nothing is too complicated here. Oh, 0.2 is maybe a tick too small, 0.5. Yeah, 0.5 is better. And then U and U, 0.2. There we are. Now everything is beautifully filleted. Okay. There we are. So that's then the way how you can create a really organic, kind of like clamshell like looking ring with the loft and twist command, and then via more sketches and Boolean cut and join and intersect, we develop the final form of the ring we would like to have.